Hello viewers, welcome to the lecture series on financial accounting. Today we shall learn in this part of the lecture about introduction to Indian accounting standard, which are popularly known as IND-AS. Today's lecture shall cover the following contents: applicability of IND-AS, objective of IND-AS, impact on taxes, list of IND-AS, benefits of IND-AS, difference in IND-AS and Indian GAAP, and difference in IAS and IND-AS. So this is broadly the content of our today's lecture, where we will learn that how and when and who are responsible for applicability of the Indian accounting standards, then why or for which purpose they are being applicable or has been made applicable on the financial statements. What are the impacts of Indian accounting standards on the taxes, that is on the MAT credits and other tax calculations? Then the most crucial part is the list of IND-AS which are being notified from time to time by MCA and other regulatory authorities. There are various notified IND-AS, and it covers almost around 39 IND-AS till now. We shall learn about the benefits of IND-AS, that how the disclosure and presentation has changed the benefits which are being accrued to the varied group of person, and how they can use this information and can be benefited by the presentation of financial statements in accordance with IND-AS. Then finally, what is the difference between the present Indian GAAPs which we are using and the international accounting standards, that what are the different parameters on which IND-AS varies from the GAAPs and IAS. We have to take an insight of the same. While dealing with this lecture, we shall also learn certain critical points in relation to the business segments also, which is very important part, that how there has been change in IND-AS in the disclosure and recognition criterias. Now, let us understand the purpose of presentation and preparation of financial statements in accordance with IND-AS. First of all, let us analyze the purpose, that what is the purpose of introduction of the IND-AS in the presentation of the financial statements. It helps to assist in development of IND-AS and its review, to assist in promoting harmonization of regulations, accounting standards and procedures relating to presentation of financial statements, to assist users of financial statement in interpreting the information contained in financial statements, to assist auditor in forming an opinion as to whether financial statements conform to IND-AS. So these are the list of purposes which are very necessary to understand the purpose of IND-AS while preparation of the financial statements. They should be in conformity with IND-AS so issued. So this slide suggests us that they help in the development and review of IND-AS, then promoting and harmonizing various regulations, accounting standards and procedural aspect in relation to the presentation of financial statements here shall mean balance sheet, statement of accounts, true and fair presentation, which is being stipulated in IND-AS, and notes to accounts as being annexed thereto, and the statement of the issues in relation to equity. To assist users in the financial statement in interpreting the information, now there are various users. It can be government, lenders, employees, creditors, suppliers. So how they are going to be benefited by the IND-AS? So coming into the picture, we will analyze it. Now, what is the scope of IND-AS? The framework deals with objective of financial statements, qualitative characteristics that determines usefulness of financial information, then definition, recognition and measurement of the elements from which financial statements are constructed, and concept of capital and capital maintenance. So when we analyze the frameworks dealing we can assess that they basically are meant for the financial statements presentation. Both the qualitative aspect and various regulations are being dealt with in it. There are various criteria such as definition criteria, various definitions are being given, recognition criteria are being given, how we are going to measure the revenues and other data that is being stipulated under these NAS. And capital and capital maintenance is very important concept which has come into picture with NAS. So, basically scope of Ind AS is to analyze the financial information in such a manner that financial statements are being useful to the various group of people who are going to make a decision on the basis of such information. Now, qualitative characteristics are being determined for the use of financial information under Ind AS. Now, let us analyze who are the users and what are their needs of information. As we have said that financial information is being analyzed and presented. So, which group of people would be needing what sort of information, we are going to analyze it. The first one is investor. Investor is going to put his decision on the basis of these financial statements, whether to invest in the company or not. So, let us understand what the slide presents. First one is investor. The providers of risk capital and their advisors are concerned with risk inherent in and return provided by their investments. They need to help them determine whether they should buy, hold or sell. Second is employees. Interested in information about the stability and profitability of their employer. They are also interested in information which enables them to assess the ability of the entity to provide remuneration, retirement benefits and employment opportunities. So from this slide we can assess that investors need to know the risk and reward criteria associated with their investment. For that very purpose they are going to make use of financial statements. They need to help determine whether they should buy, hold or sell the investment, because on the basis of the financial statements they are going to infer about the financial health of the organization, and in that way they can put a reliance on the financial statements for their decision as to buy the shares or to sell them or to hold them. So, it plays a very vital role that the financial statement should present these financial statements should present the financial information to the investor in a clear manner. Secondly is employees. Why employees needs to know about the financial information? The information in which they are interested is basically profitability, because from profitability they are going to assess how much returns or how much stability is there in the organization. Whether organization is in position to provide them remuneration, further opportunity benefits or any retirement benefit if they continue to provide their service in the organization. Next group of people are lenders, interested in information that enables them to determine whether their loans and the interest attaching to them will be paid when due. Next one are suppliers and other trade creditors. They are interested to know from the financial statements that whether the company can be able to pay the amount owing to them. So, it says that to determine whether amount owing to them will be paid when due. Then another group of people or users are customers, interested in information about continuation of an entity. So, when we analyze this slide, we can say that lenders wants to know about the information because they need to know the liquidity position, that whether there is any liquidity crunch or not, whether company would be able to pay their outstanding amount on time. Then suppliers and trade creditors also wants to know that whether amount owing to them will be paid to them. They will analyze financial information which is being presented in the financial statements. customers, they want to know about the information for continuation of an entity. That means going concern assumption they are going to check. So, these are the various group of people who will use the financial statement to infer certain financial information so that they may know about the liquidity position, they may know about the future opportunities available with the company, they may know about the risk and return associated with the company and various information of their interest they can extract from the financial statements. Now, another two other users are government and their agencies interested in the allocation of resources and therefore the activities of the entities, regulation of activities of entities, determining taxation policies, and other user is public, assist the public by providing information about trends and recent developments in the prosperity of the entity and the range of activities. Now, let us move to another aspect of our discussion, that is applicability of NAS. Ministry of Corporate Affairs, that is known as MCA, has widely notification dated 30th March 2016, issued Companies Indian Accounting Standard Amendment Rules 2016 and Companies Accounting Standard Amendment Rules 2016. MCA has also notified Indian Accounting Standards Compliance Schedule 3, General Instructions for Preparation of Financial Statements of a Company dated 6th April 2016. So, when we analyze the applicability of Ind AS, we can analyze that notification has been issued on 30th March 2016 and there has been two acts which are being impacted. Companies Indian Accounting Standard Amendments Rules 2016 and Companies Accounting Standard Amendment Rules 2016. The two has been amended and Indian AS has come into existence. MCA has further notified Indian AS compliant with Schedule 3. Schedule 3 is being used for the preparation of financial statements. So, in this way, on April 2016, the Ind AS will be applicable to the corporate entities. Furthermore, in pursuance of the objective of making financial sector parallel with the global sector, RBI and IRDA also issued advisory regarding Ind AS implementation by bank, non-banking financial companies and insurance companies. So, advisory has also been issued by RBI and IRDA to comply with the Ind AS. Now, what are the objectives of applicability of Ind AS? Why they have come into picture? The basic objective of Indian accounting standards is to remove variations in the treatment of several accounting aspects and to bring about standardization in presentation. They intend to harmonize the diversified accounting policies followed in the preparation and presentation of financial statements by different reporting enterprises so as to facilitate intra-firm and inter-firm comparison. So, when we find out that objectives of Indian AS could be firstly the standardization of the presentation of financial statements. If we standardize the presentation throughout the industry, then it will be easier for us to assess the information as being required. As we have right now discussed that there are various users and they need the financial information for their different purposes. If the financial statements are being standardized, then the variations coming in the treatment of accounting aspects could be removed. Say for example, if there is certain amalgamation or merger. So, if we take into consideration the present Ind AS, they have made a uniform policy for all the mergers and acquisitions and they have drafted that certain amendments would be made in relation to the recognition of goodwill and any other changes in the goodwill, then they have to be presented or passed through the P&L account. So, they have specified the procedures in a more clear fashion where in AS are being applicable, they have covered those aspects where Indian gaps were not considering the treatments. So, in a way, they have extended the scope of presentation, recognition and measurement of the accounting dealings. They intend to harmonize the diverse accounting policies. Now, for one particular aspect, there could be diverse accounting policies. They have tried to incorporate a composite accounting policy, say for example, in business segments, amalgamation, mergers, corporate entities, holding, where we have different AS like AS 14, 22, 21, their all impact has come into one accounting standard, that is Ind AS 103. Now, it has helped or facilitated in the making of comparison in intra-firm and inter-firm also. When firm A and firm B are going to make their financial statements as per the guidelines of Ind AS, more or less their financial statements would be on same line. So, there is standardization. A standardization helps in making the comparisons easier and inference of the information could be more viable. Now, what are the impacts of this Ind AS on taxes? Let us have an analysis of the same. In order to make the transition to Indian AS smooth, the related tax issues also need to be addressed. In this regard, the Ministry of Finance has notified 10 income computation and disclosure standards in March 15, which are known as ICDs. However, presently its application is being deferred to a later period being notified. These standards provide an independent framework for computation of taxable income, which is delinked from the statutory financial reporting by companies. That means ICD will be separate set of standards which we need to follow when preparing the tax returns. However, the basis for minimum alternative tax, that is MAT computation for companies reporting under Ind AS, still remains an issue to be addressed. So, at one end, there has been a compliance with the ICDs in the coming periods. Secondly, the MAT credit or the MAT computation has to be addressed yet under the present Ind AS, and there had been various annexures being attached to the Ind AS, which will make us understand how to deal with the taxation guidelines also. Earlier, the MAT credits as well as the computation aspect was dealt by timing difference and permanent difference under the accounting standard for taxes on income. However, there has to be certain work which has to be done under Ind AS to make the MAT computations more clearer and viable. Now, let us analyze the list of Indian accounting standards which are being notified. The first one is Indian Accounting Standard, shortly Ind AS 1. It deals with presentation of financial statements. Earlier, Indian GAAPs, that is AS 1, used to deal with the presentation of financial statements. So, disclosure as well as the policy related matters would be dealt with this standard. Second is Indian Accounting Standard, Indian AS 2, it deals with inventory. Then Indian Accounting Standard, Ind AS 7, statement of cash flow. Indian Accounting Standard, Ind AS 8, accounting policies, change in accounting estimates and error. Indian Accounting Standard, Ind AS 10, events after the reporting period. Indian Accounting Standard, Ind AS 11, it deals with construction contracts. Indian Accounting Standard 12, it deals with income taxes. Indian Accounting Standard 16, property, plant and equipment. Indian Accounting Standard, Ind AS 17, it deals with lease. Indian Accounting Standard, bracket Ind AS, that is 18th, it deals with revenue. Indian Accounting Standard, Ind AS 19, it deals with employees' benefit. Indian Accounting Standard, that is Ind AS 20, It deals with accounting for government grants and disclosure of government assistance. Indian Accounting Standard, Ind AS 21, Effect of Change in Foreign Exchange. Indian Accounting Standard, Ind AS 23, Borrowing Cost. Indian Accounting Standard, Ind AS 24, Related Party Disclosure. Then Indian Accounting Standard, that is Ind AS 27, it deals with separate financial statements. Indian Accounting Standard 28, Investment in Associates and Joint Ventures. Indian Accounting Standards 29, Financial Reporting in Hyperinflationary Economies. Such accounting standard has not yet been incorporated in our accounting standards on Indian GAAPs. It is a new concept. Then Indian Accounting Standard, Ind AS 32, Financial Instruments, its presentation. Indian Accounting Standards, Ind AS 33, Earnings per Share. Then Indian Accounting Standard 34, it deals with Interim Financial Reporting. Indian Accounting Standards 36, it deals with Impairment of Assets. Indian Accounting Standards 37, they deal with Provisions, Contingent Liabilities and Contingent Assets. Ind AS 38, it deals with Intangible Assets. Indian Accounting Standard 40, they deal with Investment Property. And Indian Accounting Standard 41 with agriculture. Beside this, there are certain other Indian accounting standards. Their numbering starts from 101. So, Indian Accounting Standard, Ind AS 101, it deals with first time adoption of Indian accounting standards. That means, what are the outcomes we are facing in the transitional provisions or transitional phase, they are dealt with under this Indian Accounting Standard. Then Indian Accounting Standard 102, it deals with share based payments. Third is quite crucial, that is Indian Accounting Standard 103, Business Segments, and it deals with certain measurement and recognition criteria when merger amalgamation takes place. Indian Accounting Standard 104, it deals with insurance contracts. In our previous accounting standards, insurance contract, for insurance contract, there has not been any stipulated Indian accounting standards separately. However, Ind AS are dealing with these standards. Ind AS 105, non-current assets held for sale and discontinuing operation. Indian Accounting Standard 106, exploration for and evaluation of mineral resources. So, it is again a very different accounting standard which we have not dealt with in our previous Indian GAAPs. Indian Accounting Standard 107, Financial Instruments Disclosure. Indian Accounting Standard 108, Operating Segment. Indian Accounting Standards 109, Financial Instruments. 110 deals with Consolidated Financial Statements. 111 for joint arrangements, 112 for disclosure of interest in other entities. Further, we have 113 for fair value measurement, 114 for regulatory deferral accounts, 115 for revenue from contracts with customer. So, with this, we have completed up the list of Indian accounting standards which have been notified so far. So, we can assess that they have broadly covered up all the aspects and they have included even those portions which were not dealt with Indian GAAPs, that is generally accepted accounting principles have left certain contracts or certain items. Now, they have specified Indian accounting standards for those areas also, plus it is more wider, there are better details of each and every transaction is being given under Indian accounting standards. So, as and when we are going to learn these accounting standards in detail, we can assess how the definition, recognition, measurement and disclosure criteria are different for various segments under NAS which are being notified. Now, students, we are going to summarize our discussion. We have today learned about the Indian accounting standards which are being issued. The Ind AS list we have learned in detail that how various Indian accounting standards are being notified, what are the benefits of these Indian accounting standards, how there has been improvement in the presentation of the financial statements, and how a financial information is being useful to the various group of people, and what information is being extracted by them from these financial statements, so prepared taking into consideration Indian accounting standards. In our upcoming lecture, we are going to learn about the various benefits from Indian accounting standards and how there is difference between Indian accounting standards and the IFRS. With this, we are ending up our discussion of today. Thank you.